Greetings. When you argue with a Mohammedan, you can tell when they stop and when they cut and paste a block of text prepared for their use. I'm not kidding, it is really obvious. Learn to recognize the shift if you do not resonate with what I'm saying right now. Let me give you an example. A Mohammedan starts his post on my video with this. Ezekiel 23, read it to your mother or sister or daughter and explain it further, you fools! Ever heard that one before? Well, after a half dozen messages I won't repeat here, I challenged the young jihadi and he replied with the following. Number 1, AIDS and homosexuality. The Holy Bible gives the cause of this cancer and blight. And then he quotes a verse from the Bible. What did you notice? A numbered, capitalized title.
Clang, clang, clang.
It should sound alarms in your head. Learn to recognize the change in style. So I did a quick Google, but not on the title. Do it on the first sentence. Google, Holy Bible gives cause cancer blight. Try it for yourself, it's kind of funny. It will take you right to Deedat's combat kit in one form or another. And that is when you know you are dealing with someone who cannot think for themselves. And worse for them, they will never even bother to look up or read the verses or understand the false claims that Deedat made. So I basically posted this message to his first message and then deleted the rest of his spam. Actually, you've got something there, my friend. Worshipping and serving the pagan deities of Arabia, including the Black Stone, is exactly what Jehovah is talking about. And the sin of homosexuality is condemned in the Word of God as just that, a sin. I appreciate the spam about Isaiah 21, my friend. It shows that Islam has no regard for truth or accurate reading of God's Word. This is one of many such false claims attempting to give Mohammed and Mohammedism some air of credibility, stealing credentials from the Bible. But if you actually looked, my friend, Isaiah does not say a burden or responsibility is given to Arabs. It is literally a burden against, almost a curse against Arabs. So it's spam when I send a few, but you can hide my messages with your jargon and falsehood. Actually, it is spam when you cut and paste text from another site. You need to learn to think for yourself, my friend. I do not allow Islamic spam on my channel, my friend. I gave you the courtesy of responding to the first message, but your other duplicated claims of Mohammed in the Bible are texts that have no mention of Mohammed if you bothered to read and understand the text. That's the funny thing, brother. You who follow Mohammed gladly accept someone else thinking for you. In this case, Ahmad Deedat and his combat kit, which you have been taught or convinced answers Christians, but they do not. I've read his combat kit, and while I have not refuted it in videos yet, it easily can be. Deedat famously misread and misquoted Bible passages because he had no regard for honesty, accuracy, or the truth. So think for yourself, and we can have a discussion. And there were a few more messages attempting to be rational with the Mohammedan. But he would have nothing to do with rational discussion. You're not worth my time, and it's not Deedat I was quoting from, and where I was quoting why from, it's fact, so why reword it? Or that's right, you're believing a book that is rewritten every year and yet no correct writing is found. Smiley face. I feel sorry for you because once I was lost too. I will pray for you that you do find guidance. And I'd done it again. Punched some poor blind kid in the face. But he was not even willing to look on Google. As I hope you did, you would see Deedat's combat kit in one form or another. Learn to recognize the deception of Satan in all its forms. When a Mohammedan suddenly sends you a post with correct spelling and grammar and punctuation, you can bet they did not author it. And after you read it, Google it and see just how quickly you can ferret out the real source. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.